What's up, everybody? I'm Becca Sapphire, and welcome back to Doki Doki Literature Club. The last one was a bit weird. But what else? Hi again, Becca. How's the waiting going? I had a guess. I'll take that. As long as it's not going bad, I'm happy that you're applying yourself. Maybe soon you'll come up with a masterpiece. I wouldn't count on that. You never know. Want to share what you wrote for today? Sure, here you go. Get my poem to Monica. Alright, I like this one. It makes me think of something Dean Shiori would like. Is that so? You and Shiori are really good friends, right? I wouldn't be surprised if you had those sorts of things in common. Well, we may be good friends, but Shiori and I are actually really different. Well, that may be the case. Maybe there's also some similarities that you wouldn't expect. The way she talks about you, it sounds like the two of you really care about each other's well-being. Even if you show it in different ways, it ends up being more similar than you think. I think that's the kind of vibe I can get when reading your poem. You sure you're not reading into this too much? I could be. Oh gosh, I sound like Yuri. But in any case, Shiori's like Dean has kind of a gentle feel to it. I can tell that she likes exploring with emotions like happiness and sadness. Who knew that someone so happy would enjoy sad things too? Yeah, it's totally unexpected. Well, to each their own. And you shouldn't be afraid to experiment a little bit either. But anyways, you want to read my poem now. I like the way this one turns out, so I hope you do too. Alright, let's take a look. The colors won't stop. Bright, beautiful colors, flashing, expanding, piercing. Red, green, blue, an endless concert of meaningless notes. The notes won't stop. Violent, creating, rage, front, squeaky, screeching, piercing. Time got to targets. Heads like playing in a chalkboard on a turntable. Like playing a vinyl on a pizza crust. An endless poem of meaningless. And the fuck? It's even more abstract than your last one. Huh. I guess it's just that way I write. I'm sorry if you don't like it. No, I never said that. It's just the kind of thing I never really seen before, I guess. Ugh. I kind of like playing with my space on a paper. Choosing where and how to space your words can totally change the mood of the poem. Yeah, no shit! It's almost like magic. The way I wrote the lines, really short, makes it feel like they're trying to speak over the noise. I see. It's still hard for me to tell what it's about, though. Sometimes asking what a poem is about isn't the right question. A poem can be as abstract as a physical expression of a feeling, or conversation with the reader. So putting it that way, not every poem is about something. Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Sometimes you find yourself facing difficult decisions. When that happens, don't forget to save your game. What the hell is going on? You never know when you might need to change your mind, or when something unexpected may happen. Wait, is that tip even about writing? What am I even talking about? That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening. What the hell? Okay. Just checking to see if everything's still here. Okay, everyone. We are all done reading each other's poems, right? I have something extra planned today, so if everyone could come sit in front of the room. Is this about the festival? Well, sort of. Do we really have to do something for the festival? It's not like we can put together anything good in just a few days. We'll just end up embarrassing ourselves instead of getting any new members. You're being a bit mean. Odd than usual. Like, I know you're mean, but this is a bit more than usual. That's a concern under mine as well. I don't really do well with last minute preparations. Don't worry so much. We're going to keep it simple, okay? We won't need much for more than a few decorations. So I've been working on posters and I've designed some pamphlets we can give out during the event. Okay, that's great and all, but that doesn't tell us what we're going to be doing for the event. Oh, sorry, I thought you heard about it already. We're going to be performing. Performing? Monica? Yeah, we're going to have a poetry performance. Each of us are going to choose a poem to recreate during the event. But the cool part is we're also going to let anyone else come up and recite a poem too. So you're always putting it all on the posters in case anyone wants to prepare ahead of time. Sidori, who's been covering posters, holds it up for us to see. Are you kidding me, Monica? You didn't even start putting the posters up, did you? Well, I did. You really think it's that bad of an idea? Well, no. It's not a bad idea, but I didn't sign up for this, you know? There's no way I'm going to perform in front of a group of people like that. I agree with Natsuki. I could never in my life do something like that. Imagine when I get Yori shakes off her head in fear. Guys, no, Yori. I understand where they're coming from. Remember when Nasori and Yui have never shared their poems with anyone until just a couple days ago? It's a lot for them to recite their poems out loud for a whole room full of people. I guess I kind of overlooked that. So I'm sorry. But I still think we should give it our best. We're the only ones responsible for the face of this club. If we start the event and each put on a good performance, that will inspire others to do the same. And the no more people who perform, the better now we will be able to show everyone what literature is all about. Yeah, it's about expressing your feelings, being intimate with yourself. Finding new horizons, having fun. That's right. And there's reasons we're all in this club today. Do you want to share with the others? To inspire them to the same feelings that brought you here in the first place? I know you do. We all know you do. And it all takes Insana finding for the room 2 minutes and reciting the poem. Then I know if you can do it. Kashi and Yui remain silent. Shiori looks worried. I guess that leaves me no choice. I agree. I don't think it's too much to ask. I think that Shiori and Monica have been trying really hard to get new members. The least we can do is help them out a little bit. Well, maybe, but it looks like Natsuki doesn't have any arguments left. Okay, fine. I guess I'll have to get it over with. Alright, well, thanks for asking. What about you, Yui? Yui, we the jocks glancing around at everyone else's says experienced faces. I guess I don't really have a choice. That's everyone. You're the best, Yui. This club is seriously going to be the death of me. Oh gosh. You'll be fine, Yui. But anyways, let's move on to the main event. I want each of you to choose a poem of yours. We are going to practice recreating them in front of each other. No way. Monica, this is too sudden. Well, if you can't recite your poem in front of the club, how are you expected to do that in front of a stranger? Oh no. Don't worry. I'll start off to help help everyone feel a bit more comfortable. Can I go next? Of course. Now let's see. Monica flips through her notebook to a specific room, her specific poem she has in mind for herself. Then she stands behind the podium. The title of this poem is The Way They Fly. Ahem. Monica begins reciting her poem. Her clear, confident voice fills the room. More than her reflected in her song. She knows exactly how to apply emotion behind each line she recreates. Brought the words to life. This is something that she does before, or is she simply in nature? A glance towards me. Everyone has their eyes on Monica. So I look amazed. Yui has an intense expression on her face, and that I don't understand. Finally, Monica finishes the recreation. The four of us applaud. Monica takes a breath and smiles. That was so good, Monica. Thank you very much. I was hoping to set a good example. Are you going next, Yui? I'll go next. Yui's fired up all of a sudden. Yui clenches a sheet of paper between her hands and stands up. Keeping her head down, she walks quickly over towards the podium. This poem is called. Yui anxiously glances at each one of us. You can do it, Yui. It's called. After image of a Simpson eye, I guess. Yui's voice shakes as she starts reading the poem. Just a moment ago, she practically refused to do this. Why have all of a sudden she put in so much effort? As Yui gets past the first couple of lines, her voice changes. It's almost like what happened when Yui gets absorbed in her books. Yui and words transform into sharp symbols of a fierce and confident woman. The poem is full of twists and turns in its structure that she expects with perfect timing. This must be a rare glimpse into the rolling fire Yui keeps concealed inside her head. Suddenly, she finishes. Everyone is stunned. Yui snaps back into reality and glances around her as she bewildered even herself. It's up to me to save the situation. I'm the first to start a line. Everyone joins me afterwards, and we give Yui the recognition she deserves. It's not that we didn't want to applaud for her, but we were caught so off guard that we must have forgotten. As we applaud, Yui holds the poem back in her chest and rushes back onto her seat. Yui, that was really good. Thank you for sharing. Looks like Yui is down for the count. Okay, I guess I'm next then. Yui hops out of a chair and cheerfully walks to the podium. This one's called My Meadow. Ah. Sorry, I giggled. Yui, it's a lot harder than that. How do you guys do it so easily? Try not to think of it like we create it in front of people. Imagine you're reciting it to yourself, like in front of a mirror or in your own head. It's your poem, so it'll come out the best that way. See. Okay then. Yui begins her poem. Somehow it feels like her soft voice was made as a perfect match. The poem isn't aimlessly cheery, like serious. It's serene and bittersweet. if I were to read this on paper, I probably would think much of it. But hearing it come from Joey's voice almost gives it a whole new meaning. Maybe this is what Joey meant when she said she likes my poems. It's like I get to reach more deeply into someone I thought I knew. Joey finishes and we applaud. I did it. Good job, Joey. Even Becca liked it. I guess that's a good sign. What does that mean? It came out nicely, Joey. The atmosphere of your poem fits you really nicely. But it might be the poem. Beat out of poems wouldn't work quite as well with that kind of delivery. I didn't really understand. In other words, I've seen poems of yours where there were gentle delivery. Wouldn't work as well. There might be a bit more force behind them, depending on what you're reading. Oh, I know what you mean. I practice that kind of thing. It's just embarrassing to do in front of everyone. Next time, I'm going to make you pick a poem that challenges you a bit more. We don't have much time for the festival, you know? Okay, who's next? Stassi? I could go up for Becca. It's not like I can compete with you guys anyways. Might as well let Becca lower everyone's standards a little before I have to do it. Nasty. It's fine. Might as well get it over with. But it's not like I have much of a selection of what to read. I'll just go with what I wrote for today. I stand up in front of the podium. Everyone has their eyes on me, making me feel terribly awkward. I recite my poem. Since I'm not exactly confident in my own writing, it's hard to put energy into it. Despite that one I finished, that's recently a plot line anyways. Kinda itch. Sorry, I'm not really good as everyone else. Don't worry about that so much. I think it's less about your ability and more about your lack of confidence in your writing. That's something that'll improve over time, though. Yeah, maybe. Alright then. Let's just leave Zimnowski. Yeah, I'm gone. Nancy Bernoulli gets out of her seat and makes her way towards the podium. The poem is called... Why are you looking at me? Because you're presenting. Anyways, the poem is called Jump. Now she takes a breath. While she starts designing a poem, her soul attitude disappears for a little. Well, she's still a little unhurt. Her poem has a rhythm and a rhyme to it. It's Nasty's trademark style, and it works surprisingly well when spoken out loud. The words feel like they bounce up and down, as if they give life. To a poem. I'm playing this game in one go, and it's kind of taking its toll on me. Nasty finishes and everyone applauds. She hops back at her seat. It wasn't so bad, was it? Easy for you to say. You better not make me do that again. Oh well. You at least feel prepared enough to recite a poem in front of other people? I mean, doing it in front of people will be way easier. I can't put on whatever face I want for other people. But when it's just my friends, it's just embarrassing. That's a surprise, Pulaski. I think it would be the other way around for me. Well, that's just how I said it, so... Well, I guess in that case, you won't have much to worry about for the festival. That said, I want to thank everyone for coming, though. It might be hard, but I hope that you all have an idea of what it's like now. Making sure you pick a poem and get enough practice before the festival, okay? I'll be making pamphlets, so let me know ahead of time what you'll be rewriting. Why am I playing a game at like 4 in the morning? Why am I doing this? Jeez. I should probably find some other poem to cite then. That's fine too. It doesn't have to be your own. I'm already pleasantly surprised that you're putting it all this effort for the club. It makes me really happy. Yes, no problem. Okay, everyone. I guess about it for today. I know the festival is coming up, but let's try to write our poems for tomorrow as well. It's been working out really nicely so far, so I'd like to continue that. As far as the festival, we'll finish planning tomorrow, and then we'll have a weekend to prepare. Monday's the big day. I can't wait. I can do this. Oh, wait. I stand up. There's no way I'll be able to find some extensive studying or more back. But I'll do my best to get it together. For the sake of the club, impressing Monica, I'll have to do my best. Ready to go? Yep. Looks like you two always go home together like that. It's kind of adorable, isn't it? Jeez, guys. Don't make such a big deal out of it. Must be a little nice, though. Well, how am I supposed to respond to that? It's okay, Becca. You don't have to say it. Whatever. Let's go already. Walk home, sorry, once more. Even though it's only been a few days, a lot of things have happened, changed. But today, Shoei is being a little quieter than usual on the way home. Hey, Shoei. Sorry, I was spacing out. No boy. I was thinking about something from earlier. Like how we get to, Shoei fumbles with her words. So, let's just say that one day Yuri asked to walk home with you. Huh? What would you do? What kind of question is that? Kind of putting me on the spot there. Well, I'm gonna save. Even though that one bitch creeped me the fuck out. I would walk home. Siri, you really didn't care what did you for Yuri? But she's so beautiful and smart. Jeez. I already see her in the club every day. Besides, you always seem to really like what's going on. I wouldn't just ruin that for you. You're so silly. You think about me too much sometimes. Yuri wouldn't deserve it if she wanted it, so. Yuri, I've already made up my mind. I really can't figure you out sometimes. Sorry. Besides, what's the point of speculating something that's never going to happen? Conversation trails off. It's kind of weird. You had a thing for Shoei to care so much about. But I want to respect her and keep her happy too. Then again, the festival's only a few days away. Who knows what'll happen at that time? I guess we'll make another poem. Might as well. Creepy how she jumps in excitement for that. Frightening, fear, anxiety, alone, depression, disaster, massacre. You know, if you read into this, this says a lot about their personalities. Graveyard, unstable, pain, and I'm gonna leave this episode here. See you guys in the next one. Bye!